Hello students, welcome back to Narayana Digital Classes. Today we will be solving the assignment number 39 on the topic thermodynamics. Let's move on to the assignment. Here the first question, the work done by weightless piston in causing an expansion. The delta V at constant temperature when the opposing pressure P is variable is given by, right? So here there is a system which has a weightless piston, right? This is a weightless piston. So the work done by the system here, the work done by the system. So if the system is doing a work, then what happens? Then we can observe the expansion of system by moving the weightless piston to upwards, right? So the here the volume is V1, here the volume is V2. So in expansion, the volume V2 is always greater than V1. V2 is always greater than V1, right? Then delta V equal to V2 minus V1, which is equal to positive value, right? And we know that the work done by the system, then W equal to done by the system, W is negative. Right? We know the work formula, that is W equal to minus P delta V, right? So here P is expressed in terms of variables, right? For that we need to integrate the pressure, then work will be the minus integration of P delta V, right? So this is the work. Clear? So the correct option is first option. Let's move on to the next question. Here the question, the work done by a system in an expansion against a constant external pressure is. So just now we discussed, here in expansion volume V2 greater than V1, then delta V equal to V2 minus V1, which is positive. So this is expansion, the work done by the system. Then W will be the negative, right? We know the formula, W equal to minus P delta V. So this is the work done by the system in an expansion at constant external pressure. So the W equal to minus P delta V. So the correct option is second option. Let's move on to the next question. Here vibrational energy is, right? So they have given different options. So it may be kinetic energy, it may be potential energy, it may be partially kinetic and partially potential energy. Let's see. So there is an object. So which is vibrating. This object is vibrating. So we can observe the movement of this object. Right? So this object is vibrating, that means this is moving from left onwards and right onwards, right? So here while the object is moving, then it has the kinetic energy. So these are the two points, extreme points of this object. This is the mean point, right? So at extreme point that object has the potential energy, while it's moving that object has kinetic energy. So at mean point the object has the most
highest kinetic energy. That is the highest kinetic energy, and according to law of conservation of mass, so the how much amount of potential energy is converted into kinetic energy, same amount of kinetic energy, as well as the same amount of kinetic energy is converted into potential energy. So the object has the potential energy at extreme points, and it has the kinetic energy at mean point as well as moving in the path, right? So we can say that vibrational energy is the partially kinetic energy and partially potential energy. So the correct option is first option. Let's move on to the next question. Here the question, which are the correct to express work terms, right? So the first one, work. So we know that work equal to force into distance, right? So to replace the object, we need to, replacement means it is moving from some distance to another distance, and we need to apply some force. So that is, we can say that their work will be happening. So we can measure the work, we can express the work by the product of two factors. One is intensity factor and another one is capacity factor, right? So where capacity factor is measure of extent of work, capacity factor measures the extent of work, and the intensity factor is measure the force responsible for work, force responsible for work. So in this, work is force into distance, right? So here force is the intensity factor and distance is capacity factor, right? So the first option is correct option. Let's see the second one, electrical work. Electrical work, E into NF, right? So that is also there, E is the intensity factor that we know, that is responsible for the electrical work, and NF is the capacity factor. And next thing, second option is also correct. And the next thing, expansion of work. While expansion, pressure is main thing, right? Pressure is important that there. So expansion, there is no any external pressure applied on the system. So the pressure is the intensity factor and volume. So while expansion, the volume will be increased. Volume will be increased. That is measure of extent of work, right? If you, the work done by the system, then volume will be increased in the expansion. So the P is intensity factor and delta V is the capacity factor. So the third option is also correct. So all the options are correct options, right? So the correct option is fourth option, all of the above. Clear? So I hope you understand very well. With this, I come to the end of the session. Thank you very much.